We get some metals from the sea, but most from the Earth's crust, the Earth's hard outer layer. The crust is mostly made of compounds, but it also contains some elements such as copper, silver, mercury, platinum, and gold. So what is the composition of Earth's crust? If you could break down all the Earth's crust down to elements, you could find it is almost half oxygen. Here is why. You see, the Earth's crust is composed of 45% oxygen, 8% aluminum, iron 6%, calcium 5%, magnesium 3%, sodium 2.5%, potassium 1.5%, and silicon is about 27%, over a quarter, and all other metals and non-metals around 2%. Note: two non-metals, oxygen and silicon, make up nearly 3/4 of the crust. If they occur together in compounds such as silicon dioxide, which is silica or sand, oxygen is also found in compounds such as iron 3 oxide, aluminum oxide, and calcium carbonate. Look, just 6 metals, aluminum to potassium, make up over 1/4 of the crust. Aluminum is the most abundant of these, and iron next. All 6 elements occur as compounds because they are reactive, scarce, and precious. All the other metals together make up less than 2% of the Earth's crust. Many, including lead, zinc, and copper, are considered scarce. Gold, silver, platinum, and palladium are called precious metals because they are scarce, expensive, and often kept as a store of wealth. The car industry uses a lot of metals. Cars are mainly steel plus over 5% aluminum, but the steel is coated with zinc and the bumpers with nickel and chromium. The electrics depend on copper. The battery uses lead, and the modern exhausts contain palladium, platinum, and rhodium as catalyst. Metal ores. The rocks in the Earth's crust are a mixture of substances. Some contain a large amount of the metal compounds, or one metal, so it may be worth digging them up to extract the metal. So what are ores? Ores are rocks from which metals are obtained. For example, rock salt, the main ore of sodium. It's mostly sodium chloride. Another example is bauxite. Bauxite is the main ore of aluminum. It is mostly aluminum oxide. Since gold is unreactive, it occurs native, uncombined. This sample is almost pure gold. To mine or not to mine. Before starting to mine an ore, the mining company must decide whether it is economical. It must find answer to questions like this. First, how much ore is there? Second, how much metal will we get from it? Third, are there any special problems about getting the ore out? Fourth, how much will it cost to mine the ore and extract the metal from it? The cost will include roads, buildings, mining equipment, the extraction plant, transport, fuel, chemicals, and wages. Fifth question, how much will we be able to sell the metal for? And the last question, here we go. So, will we make a profit if we go ahead? The answers to these questions will change from year to year. For example, if the selling price of a metal rises, even a low quality or low grade ore may become worth mining. Another issue is that we should worry about the population. You see, the local people may worry that the air will be spoiled and the air and the rivers polluted, so they may object to plans for a new mine. On the positive side though, they may welcome the new jobs that mining will bring. You see? Win-win.